Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Daily Tarot, and these are your money, career, finance focus reading for the sun, moon and the rising sign of Cancer. Please keep in mind that this is your group general reading for the month of August 24. Since it's a group reading, so please pick it up what resonates with you. Please leave the rest for others. And also, in case you need to have a personal, private, detailed, extended reading, my email ID, my website is mentioned in the description box below. Please keep in mind, all personal, private reading, healing processes, hypnotherapy sessions, past life regression therapy sessions, inner child, and you know, any chronic disease, whatever session you are planning booking for yourself, or personal private sessions are pre-booked, pre-slotted and pre-purchased. Please connect with me with that understanding. I really appreciate that. And don't forget to mention your time zone, because I work in an IST time zone. So when you book a reading or a healing therapy with me, I need to match the mutual availability as per two time zones. So please do mention that. And if you really like what I do on the channel, please do like, subscribe the channel and put on the notifications. Now I'm going to do your detailed oracle card reading, Cancer people, and then I'm going to do your tarot card reading with couple of angel messages more. And you are good enough full moon in Virgo. This card is giving me a lot of intimations that if you were in any self-doubt, any anxiety, any stress, that was temporary. But then, you know, you also need self-introspection frequently. You also need to see that where you have space to improve, but you are actually good enough to handle any professional situation coming your way. It also says that, you know, you need to fill up the gap through your own understanding. Maybe you can connect with people, but then you have all the power, capability, skills to actually make yourself whole and to make yourself complete for any challenges or obstacle coming your way ever into your professional life. And the other card you have is emotions are running high. So there is a possibility that you are becoming too emotional over certain things in your professional life, or rather I should say, or I'm sensing that you are taking too many things personally. You know, in case you want to look up to your professional heights, you want to really excel into your professional, journey, it is very important that you are not getting judgmental about people, about situation, and you are trying to take things neutrally as far as possible. More you are engaging into personal conflicts, personal politics, and you know, more you are taking things personally to you, that is only going to harm you. The card is loud enough to tell you that you need to disconnect from the situation, or maybe you're getting too attached with certain situations, certain associations, which is definitely not going well with you at the current point of time. With this, you also have a full moon in Virgo. That means the month of September is going to be a little rewarding month for you. So I will not say only the month of September, because we are doing this reading in the month of August. So yes, both the months are going to be the receiving the reward period for you, but provided you are taking this development as a holistic development, not just a professional in the emotional space, but you are trying to look at the bigger picture, that how this reward, how this receiving, or how the resolution or something which is getting completed in August and September month, how you are getting the best benefit out of that situation, and where you are using this learning for your own benefit in time to come. And the other card you have is meditate and contemplate, and this is new moon in Pisces. So yes, there is a possibility that either you start something in the something new, that could be a new piece of work, new project, new contract. So something you're starting either in the month of August, or maybe then I'm sensing the period of March is also going to be very, very promising for you. But then you need to peace out, you need to calm a little bit, do some meditation, do some self-introspections, and I am sure things are going to get sorted for you very, very soon. So overall, If you see your moonology reading, yes, there are few completions, there are few starting, but you need to work only on yourself primarily by getting non-judgmental, neutral as far as possible. Now let us see what messages do we have from the Goddess Oracle card. We have a card of Medicine Woman, which says you are a channel for divine healing power. So in case you are able to do anything for people around you, even for yourself, if you are able to give an outlet to that spirituality, that spiritual awakening within yourself or spiritual awareness, that kind of profession is one of your core life purpose, one of the purpose for which you have taken birth on Mother Earth. So if you are not in different, if you are in a different profession, and if you feel that, oh, I don't still want to take spirituality as my core profession, it's absolutely right, because that's your free will. There has to be an inner calling, but the only thing needed at this point of time is that you may start some volunteer efforts towards this particular cause or inner calling whenever you feel you are ready, you're there to contribute, and that is making any sense to you in time to come. And the other card you have is, oh my goodness, so you're getting a lot of spiritual message today, that too into a money career reading. Cancer, it says you are a magical person who can manifest your clear intentions into reality. Now, this is only going to happen once you are in a neutral state of mind. But then this card is a very strong indication that you are in a very powerful period of manifestation. So the moment you are going to visualize anything, you will see that the manifestation has started. And it says that you have a true power to manifest what you want at this point of time. So yes, it is going to become reality very soon. But then I would like to suggest that choose one thing which you want to visualize, choose one thing which you want to manifest on priority at the moment and work towards that. Don't scatter, waste your energy, because if you have scattered thought, there is going to be a lot of energy leakages. And then you also have a card of purification. Yes, it's a detoxification time. You will see people coming, going. There's a change in the set of people. You know, maybe you are moving to another group of people, like-minded people. Maybe you will sense that, oh, your existing group is not involving you, or you are not involving in that group. You are not resonating with them, and it's the other way around as well. So, you know, when there is a transformation happens, you also go through groups detoxification. You move from one group to another. You move from existing people known to unfamiliar faces. And there is a complete shift which comes over. And that is one of the way of detoxification. It's time for cleansing, detoxification of your body and mind. You will also see certain professional engagements, associations, collaborations, relationships coming to an end, because you are going through a different phase right now. People, connections, association, those are over in your life. Their karmic role is over. Whatever lessons you were supposed to learn from them, the wisdom you were supposed to get from them, the maturity you were supposed to get from that situation, circumstances or collaboration, that has been done, and now you're moving into another life lesson. So you will see a change in that zone. Your mindset is also going to change, but the only thing you need to be consciously be aware this month is you need to work on your emotional side. And you know, there is no point in taking anything emotional or personal or especially onto you, pinpointing yourself. So don't be into the zone of being victim or in a guilty zone. Now let us see what fairy messages do we have for you today. We have ask for what you want. And you already have a beautiful card which says the manifestation is at its peak in the month of August. Try to utilize this time as far as possible, because you may get something very big purely on the power of manifestation which you truly hold. Cancer, you guys are water signs, and water signs are always much more intuitive than anybody else, because you know the phases of, you know, each and every time period so well. So try to use your manifestation power and try to keep yourself as far as clean from your thoughts, from your emotions, from your feelings, so that you receive what you truly want in no time. And then the other card you have is definitely get some exercise. And I was telling you about your intuition at the moment, but it says as your body becomes stronger, you begin to feel stronger in all ways. This is keeping good care of yourself mentally, emotionally, physically, and it is telling you to keep a holistic well-being on priority. And then the other card you have is yes, your birthday. So yes, you know, the birthday season is going to be, or you know, whenever this year or next year, expect that there will be major changes coming during that particular time. And that is why it says a significant birthday holds the answer to your question. So if you still have questions, your birthday season, the time limit given by your divine angel is that during that period you may see some major changes, but the changes which you are going to witness during your birthday at any point of time, that is going to be the life changing. Some major changes are expected to happen during that particular period. Now let us see what messages do we have in the first week of August. And we have a card of Three of Pentacles. And we have the Hanging Man. And we also have a card of Seven of Cups in the first 15 days. Let us see what messages do we have in the second part of August. We have Six of Cups. So again, yes, too much of emotions, your own sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energies, too much into your reading. A beautiful star coming in the second week of or second part of August. That's a major, major good news. And then you have a Page of Wands in the second part of August. Let us also see what guidance do we have for both the periods. In the first period, you have Four of Pentacles. And in the second part of August, you have Eight of Cups. So if you see, you have a lot of cups today in the reading, Cancer people. You have to be very cautious that you are not flowing along with your emotions. Don't flow with the flow. Try to balance yourself. Try to regain your peace, your calmness. Be centered. Be centered before taking any major decision during this particular period. And yes, there could be some confusion, some dilemma, some illusion in the first part of August, ranging from 1st to 15th of August. But this is going to be a temporary period. Maybe there will be a lot of options, a lot of choices, and you might be in a dilemma what to choose. Now the card says, your advice card says, hold on. Don't take any major decision. There is no action needed from your side in the first 15 days. Hold on tightly whatever you have in your hand. It's not the time to leave things abruptly. And then you also have a card of Three of Pentacles, which says, again, you will get more work, better work, quality work when you're working with team, when you're working in groups. And also it's an indication to people who are working as a freelance, you know, as an individual, it's time to go back to join organizations. And then the Hanging Man is definitely a card of little adjustments, compromise, modification needed from your end. But you know, in case you're getting your peace, your calm, if you feel that you are learning, and there is no harm if you are adjusting with the situation, or if you're molding at the time being, for the time being, what you want, I don't see there is any harm, because the first 15 days is all about you regaining, retaining your balance. I'm trying to tell you this thing again and again, because that is some of the major goals you need to achieve in the month of August, that to first 15 days especially. Now your second period, the second last 2 weeks of August is a very interesting one. You have someone coming back from your recent past. Maybe your ex-employer, your ex-boss, your colleague. And they come not just, you know, to give you happiness, to help you in crisis, but it comes to offer you some kind of opportunity, which is going to be very, very good for you, because the card which is following Six of Cups is a card of Star. That means someone who returns back into your life comes with a big bang, with a big news, helping you to really relive your professional life, relive your financial status. Maybe if you are in a need of a loan, you need money, you need help in money, someone from your past, your professional friend, your personal, anybody will come from your past, someone known to you will come and help you in that during struggle period. But then it's a very, very positive sign. And you also have a card of Page of Wands, which is actually a situation that you're going to receive a lot of needed messages related to your work and emails and phone calls. And I also see that you might come up with a new creative, innovative idea during the second part. And you might consider this as a short-term partnership or a short-term side business or a parallel, you know, freelance kind of work. Maybe in future you might would like to convert this idea, this interest or passion into a money making venture. Now if I see your second part of the reading, I do have a cup of eight of cup, which says that you might leave, you know, few of you might leave your current association because you feel that you have poured enough, you know, compassion, love, your heart and soul in a situation, and you are not being reciprocated well, and that's the reason you feel that you're not respected, you're not getting that name, fame, you're not getting that connection revival. And finally, you decide to move on from that association. So yes, there is a possibility that you might look up to new opportunity because you are not happy in the emotional side. Now, this is not about money. It is about that, you know, everything is okay, but now your goals are different. You're not able to resonate with your organization goal or with the goal where you are connected. This is definitely departing away from the existing long-term association, and this is going to be true for a lot of you. I do see that, you know, finally you will be moving away from whatever you are doing at the moment or whatever association you are into. Now let us see what angel therapy is going to be helpful for you during this period. And you have a card of Ascender Masters, which says powerful, loving and wise spiritual teachers are watching over you and guiding you. This is an intimation, Cancer people, it's time for you to connect with your mentors, your teachers, your coaches, because they are the real guiding force behind your current professional standing. And this is something which will help you in time to come. And your final angel of abundance message is successful funding. Your idea is divinely guided. I told you that you might get some idea, some creative idea, some innovative idea, which you might would like to convert into business at the later stage. It says your idea is divinely guided and supported by the same infinite wisdom of God that gave you the idea. Do not allow money concerns to prevent you from turning it into reality. Crowdfunding, partnerships and other investments are also available for your help. And your last card of the reading is visualize abundance in all form. My God. So this month you are at your peak in visualization and manifestation. Make it your priority on a daily basis. It says God gave you such great spiritual power that everything you visualize, eventually it becomes yours in reality. Hold a steady vision of that which is beautiful for you, healthful, positive, and it filled with great blessings. And that is what you are going to experience beautifully, truly, and in reality in the month of August for sure. It's a very powerful month for you, Cancer people. The only thing is that you have to handle yourself. Don't be emotional at this month, and you know, be very, very innovative in your visualization and manifestation. You are going to get what you manifest for sure. Do let me know how you resonated with this group reading. This is not a personal private reading. For any personal private detail extended reading ranging from half an hour to an hour, you may connect with me, and I will see you next time very soon. Be blessed.